Winters is all about hot garma-garam soups, and summers is all about foods that are cooling in nature. Yes, juices, soups, salads, soups, cold soups. Hey guys, it's me, the Bombay chef Varun Inamdar, and welcome to Rajshri Food, which is the ultimate destination for vegetarian recipes. Talking about cold soups, I'm doing the king of all cold fruits, the Spanish gazpacho. Well, gazpacho as a traditional soup is made with tomatoes, which are nice, plump and red. But of course, over the years, there are a lot of fruit gazpachos also that are available. You can use watermelons, melons, cantaloupes, and just keep thinking nice, loud and wide. Let's cut these into rough pieces. The entire quantity of tomatoes mentioned in the recipe is divided into two parts. Half of it is going to get chopped or cut roughly, and the other half is juiced up, almost like a puree. No blanching, no cooking, no processing, just raw tomatoes, washed, cut into pieces, and blended into a fine, thin juice. It's important to have all these ingredients absolutely nice and fresh, because that is the essence and beauty of this soup, gazpacho. I'm just keeping a little aside, because eventually this needs to be garnished with something like a salsa, so let's keep that aside. I'm also taking cucumber. Wash all these vegetables nicely before they come onto your kitchen table, and then it just becomes an easy process. Cut these roughly, and all of this needs to get transferred into a larger bowl. To this, I'm adding in a little bit of onion, maybe just a quarter, and that's fine. This is just to bring in that element of freshness in the recipe. Just open all these petals up so that when we marinate it, they get wonderfully flavored. Now to this recipe, you can also add in yellow bell peppers, red bell peppers, a touch of green bell peppers. Make it nice and colorful, make it nice and loaded with vegetables. But the traditional gazpacho is just basic few ingredients. And to this, we also want to add in bread. Now bread in this case, could be an old baguette, an old focaccia, an old ciabatta, or just sliced breads. Just tear it up roughly. The bread in this recipe is not just for flavor, but also to ensure that the soup becomes nice and thick, almost naturally. Do not overdo this component, otherwise your soup will become extremely sluggish, and that's not something that you're looking at. It has to be nice, fresh, and soup-like. Remember, that's the consistency which is very important in this case. Let's add in some olive oil. This is olive oil of very good quality, because like I said, it's that freshness in this recipe which is very important. Let's add in white vinegar. You can also add in a touch of balsamic vinegar if you can lay your hands on that. Now all these ingredients are in a way to balance each other's flavors. Tomatoes are tart, lightly sweet. You add in some vinegar, accentuate that. To balance all of this, this is my personal touch. I know the Spanish won't like this, but I like adding in just a pinch of sugar just to balance all the flavors, just to bring that element of neutrality in this recipe. I'm adding in a few cloves of garlic, a few leaves and stalks of coriander. Very little, because this may end up changing the color of this recipe, or the soup for that matter. A touch of salt. This is the only time you're going to add salt in this recipe. So ensure that you use that with caution. You add in tomato juice. Now this is fresh tomatoes run into a pulp, a puree, or a juice, whatever you call this. To just bring in that balance of flavor, I'm going to crack in some black peppercorns. Well, this is a summer treat. So remember, do not overdo your spices, because in summers, you like things which are nice, cooling, breezy, and not overtly hot or spicy. Let's mix all of this well. And once that's done, you keep this aside, rather refrigerated, for at least 2 hours. Well, if you have all the time in hand, keep this overnight, and then you'll see this most amazing gazpacho getting churned, nice and chilled. Cover this and keep this refrigerated. Our soup mixture is nice and chilled. The next step is to grind this nice and fine. But before that, one stir to ensure that all of this gets mixed one last time. Of course, we're going to mix it again, but this will just ensure that all of it just comes together. What you'll notice is that the vegetables will release some moisture, some water, because these are all vegetables with very high content of water. But all of that will also get absorbed by the bread slice at the same time. So let's begin grinding this. Of course, you need to do this in batches. Otherwise, you'll mess up the entire work table. Let's give this yet another mix to ensure that all of this is uniform in taste, flavor, texture, and color. The next step is to make the garnish. For the garnish, I've kept some onions, tomatoes, and cucumber aside. Let's cut this nice and fine, almost like a salsa. Cucumber, just gonna cut it midway and ensure that the seeds are removed off. Similarly, we also need to cut the tomato, which has been kept aside. Cut into half, a quarter further down, and then remove the seeds. We mix all of this on the cutting board itself. If you can possibly cut this a little in advance, keep it nice and chilled, and of course, nothing like it. Let's transfer the soup into a chilled bowl, because remember, it's a cold soup. To this, I'm going to add in some of these cut vegetables, make it look nice and colorful. Top this up with some extra virgin olive oil. And finally, last but not the least, some freshly cracked black pepper. With this, your chilled Spanish gazpacho is done and ready. Do try this chilled soup this summer and share your experience in the comment section. And for more such vegetarian recipes, stay tuned to Rajshri Food. Bye for now.